Jim Craig, here I come. Waiting this game to end.
It's the NFL playoffs on EA Sports, and we are at Victory First Energy Stadium in Cleveland. Straight ahead, it's a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl. And it'll be a great one between the Miami Dolphins and the Cleveland Browns.
To return here in 2 weeks' time for Super Bowl 56. Here we go from Los Angeles. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24 at their own 24-yard line.
Second and 10. A very chilly day here, but no snow. And mean, I gotta say, it's
great. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy.
And this is caught. Touchdown.
I missed that field goal. Greasy motherfucker, man. I gotta watch him. I gotta watch him. I gotta watch his ass. I forget I had the slow kick. And I thought I was gonna jump up real fast. He was talking shit to Craig, made him mad.
He had the option to hand that
Solomon.
I think it's safe to say that he made the right decision.
During the season, talking about what he want to do, he want to win. He ain't won this and that.
It's not going to keep the ball. You know, in the NFL, that's usually not the recipe for being around too long. So when you do keep it, it often surprises the
defense. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
I gotta hit Craig with some shit that he don't run. I want this game, Craig, but we can't turn no turnovers. We cannot make more turnovers than him. Cannot. Oh, timeout. We cannot make more timeouts than him. We cannot. I mean, no more turnovers than he do. Gotta make less turnovers. Play smart with this motherfucker.
Hey, check 24.
With that bullshit, man. Weak ass shit, Craig. 14 yards and it moves the sticks. Get on his ass, y'all. 10 upcoming from Browns territory at the 38.
Haskins gonna throw again.
Spare me, man. For real.
Craig, I know how you like to play.
Right there.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal.
Man, get the fuck out of here. Ain't no way in my mind letting motherfuckers come through there like that.
And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming in.
Now let's enjoy the conversation, folks. Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
No! You gonna man up on your ass, buddy.
It's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case. You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down that leads to a second and 10. Play action, now it's Tua. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the way out there, but it'll be third down.
So far,
I got nothing to lose with you, Craig. Nothing to lose. I ain't got nothing to lose, man. Nothing to lose.
We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? The interesting sequence of plays for the day.
Does it alter the factor back all in with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense making a great play and continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if you're going to be ready to take the pressure off and run the ball.
And he'll fight forward, maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's over. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four.
Oh, Craig. Oh, Craig. Let's go, Craig. Get that. Damn it. Just my luck that motherfucker be right there. I can beat you, Craig. I'm coming for that ass, man.
Himself to pass it. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that is incomplete.
Hell no.
contact. Brings up second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit, huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
He's going to let one go deep for Parker. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Devontae Parker, 36 yards. And the Dolphins are able to create the lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone. And it changes the way you approach the second half as well. Now you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better, too, having that lead.
And that'll carry him for the back over to the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Malik Hooker. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try to get some more points.
Flushed out right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 15 seconds remaining.
Complete in the end zone.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Who got the ball first? Did I get it first? I think I got it first.
Now they'll try to convert on the front six and five. Looking to pass. Escaping the pressure, going deep here for Parker.
Unbelievable.
They weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. So we come upon halftime in the AFC title game. As we said, you know, to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, one more half to decide who takes home the Lamar Hunt Trophy.
Yeah, they're making the screen move fast, slow, all that shit. Come on.
And a penalty marker's down on the field. That holding call set him off. Not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. So that's a great starting field position as well.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Here's Gaskin. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, in on the stop.
Can resolve that one. A nice 4-yard gain, so you can use that to facilitate a reaction game.
Now we can come right back and continue to run the football because, as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Down to it.
Lord have mercy.
He's got a man complete. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
To number 16.
A big play there. 82 yards. And the Dolphins handle the lead. Charles fans are on here. They're talking Super Bowl.
made plans. You just can't look past anybody in this league, especially this deep into the playoffs.
I gotta stop buffing them like that. They ain't fast enough for that play. I must keep a man back there.
Especially the way they're handling the floor, right? You didn't expect this part to happen when you're betting this deep in the
playoffs.
Every team's dangerous. Cleveland offense ready to go. And last time, one play interception.
And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play call. Because one play drive, we throw an interception. I think the very next time out, don't give them a chance on play action. I think maybe you go play action for your quarterback. Offense in, and then throwing another one.
They're going deep for him. Inside the 20.
Damn it.
It's a big play there for the Browns. 57 yards. Time is going to stop at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
At the 18-yard line.
On second and 12, Stafford to the goal line, but it's incomplete. Jalen Reagor is the intended receiver, and it's third down. The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
That's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Stafford.
No! How did he get up that fucking head? How? How's Malik Hooker playing linebacker, man? No, get the fuck out of here, man.
If it's going to nerve him a little bit, does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to put it together and become sharp again?
Cotton ball, man.
Let's go. Come on, capitalize on this one. He'll fire it deep for Reagor. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in. And big play that time for Cleveland. 45 yards. First and goal. They got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
This defense just playing, getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
They've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second? And he is into the end zone. Touchdown. Taking it in for 3 yards. And the first turnover. Backwards on first down, but this time he forces his way in.
Now, what do you think of this? Just a little bit more help, and I can get it done on this one. Maybe even overall the play call from the sideline. Just feeling like he had that opportunity, and he wanted to cash it in.
Taken in about 4 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19. So he probably should have opted for the touchdown.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Dolphins have the lead ready for their next drive. Their lead down.
down to two scores after the touchdown. They start with the first and ten. And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Marking down at the 49. Getting it to him in space. Pays off big time. That winds up going for 31. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for first and ten. Here's Tagovailoa. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles. So just gets one.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
AFC Championship tilt. Third quarter play. This is second and ten.
That motherfucker just to get it in there.
Real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive chance, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
Brings up second and goal at the 4 yard line.
I need this touchdown.
Four down territory.
Hey, check it out.
Operating from the gun.
Stafford. No! He's throwing the ball away. Nobody there. They still giving him. They ain't calling shit on this nigga. Get on this nigga ass, y'all. On his ass, man. What are you talking about,
to start the drive. They have to make that up and then some on second and 13. 29 is the mic. Stafford toward the end zone. Oh! Jalen Brager was the receiver. But now it's third down. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning. Is it a
bottom? That was a touchdown. He knew it.
As a visiting team, as an underdog, you were right. They've done just that. And look where it's gotten them.
It's not the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key. And this was the right answer in this one.
And that's going to be caught. Touchdown. This one in. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes when the defense needs to find the little guys.
Did you see they just tried to give him a field goal block? Fuck, man was holding my field goal that long for.
Short, wide, skinny, whatever.
Craig shit like.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25.
That's when this nigga come up with all the tricky shit. Come on, man. Come on. Come on, gang. Come on. Don't cut out, man. Don't fucking cut out, man.
I'm curious to see Charles about the play calling on this drive. Last time out the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close to the score game.
If I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball. Throw glass, what you gonna do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, you can end up in enemy's hands again.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. This is Gaskin with a carry. He'll take this for about four, up to the 46-yard line.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one he's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of him, paramount, he got it done.
Nursing that sideline jersey.
Like a guy who understands the situation, also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what,
If you drop this one, you'll be carried around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's a big guy.
Action fake. They'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And down to the 28-yard line. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. First set of downs now. They've got a field goal.
And defensively, backbreaker. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. And that'll bring up second down.
They've been giving up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Once again, to the 28. They'll try and run some pressure, trying to get it on the ground. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. The objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but that's a problem.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three.
Flag, hold it. God damn it.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So far.
Got him! Got his ass!
And his defense here going to work their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time.
Don't try me, Craig. Don't try me, boy. Tell him.
Possession,
you try your ass. I ain't lying to you. I'm trying your ass.
The Browns drive about to get started, and they are in need of points here, no doubt about that. With a Super Bowl berth on the line.
Yeah, you're right. Let me not try to score too fast. This motherfucker. That motherfucker will come back and score so fucking fast. That's how I've been losing against Craig. That's just how I've been losing to him. Damn, the screen will lag me like that? The opponent is having some network issues.
Tackle this guy. Fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
Yeah, D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not
gonna. How many people you got watching that motherfucker?
So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get your reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after that. 4 yards to pick up. First down.
Oh. I'm not gonna go there now. I'm not gonna try to score my ass.
So from the 36,
I'm definitely trying to try to score him.
He's back to throw. He's gonna let it fly. And that gonna be
in. Why the screen fall like that, man? Come on, Madden, what the fuck is y'all doing?
Expected it and got there and popped it free.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10.
No, man, no. Oh, man. No, man. Man, come on, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. I should have went with my first mind, man. I'm talking about it was like the game just took it to him, man. Jason to kick off for Miami. I shouldn't have did the same play back to back.
So they throw the pick another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
You, the way that you called for the shot there, that's perfect though, because there is something to that. Being a safety allows you freedom to move around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Oh, with that pussy shit, play me. You up 15 points. Play me. You up 12 points. Play me. Harrison ass over, man. Man, run that motherfucker over, man. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense. Damn it. Afraid to play me. I'm afraid to play me. I'm gonna take a knee. I'm gonna take this motherfucker. I'm telling you right now. Don't play with me. Play with me, Craig. Play with me, Craig.
Evidence they need, partner, that understand that they'll start to slow him down. It's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just trying to play. And let's face it, coming into
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Back to throw is 2 and 4. They'll take a shot for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams.
Myself and the entire crew will see you in 2 weeks at the Super Bowl.
Huh? I can't hear Craig.